and MBS Sobha here to talk a little bit more about the outlook when it comes to the strong pre-sales as well as what more is required to rekindle the real estate sector. Mr. Sharma, good morning. Great to have you on ET Now. Now, the pre-sales momentum has been seen and that was earlier strong. It's weakened quite a bit. Which of the regions have seen a weak momentum, and do you believe that this is a one-off, that things will improve, or is this some sort of a decisive trend according to you?
Good morning to all your viewers and great to be there on your channel. See, as far as the operational performance is concerned, we used to do about 3 million square feet a year till about couple of years back. And in India, the real estate slowdown has started since 2013. From there, now we have migrated to 1 million square feet or so per quarter, 4 million square feet for last 6 to 7 quarters. And this augurs well. We have to realize that the macro environment today has got two parallel forces working. On the one hand, you see that the residential space is struggling due to multiple regions where the government also has taken note of it. On the other hand, the commercial space is doing exceedingly well, and this is one sector which is somehow keeping our Indian economy on a better shape. We are in this sector for such a long haul, where we believe that we have a role to play, that the role to ensure that in our core markets where we have the presence, to be either number one or number two in due course. In Bangalore, we have achieved this kind of a leadership position. In Kerala, we have achieved this kind of a leadership position with three cities, and we are focusing on NCR and Chennai. We have to do a lot in case of Pune, and in Ahmedabad, Gift City, we have started with a good note. And we believe this sector has a role to play for a couple of decades in India's growth story, and we would be there is our firm belief.
Realization trend panning out in key segments? Other developers have hinted at weakening trends. Have you faced any pressure or do you expect any going forward?
See, we have got about 6,800 and odd realization per square feet, which can be considered quite reasonable. And probably we command about 8 to 10% premium, similar location, similar product, in a particular region, which is allowing us to sustain and maintain our margins in these difficult times. We also agree that the pricing power with the real estate developers is quite restricted, and it is not easy to increase the prices. And rather, we need to spend today much higher amount in gaining the customer to our account. So the sales promotion expenditures are at elevated levels. But fortunately, the core construction cost has remained stable, and this is allowing us to ensure that we protect the margin and be more viable to our clients.
So tell me, how is the contractual side of the business? How has that performed in the quarter gone by? And how is it that you're scaling this up as opposed to the other segments? And what percentage of your revenue mix now do you intend to get this from?
See, as far as the contracting division is concerned, this is the reflection of the business model our company has been following. This backward integration model has allowed us not only to do our jobs on time, where all our projects from a real estate perspective, RERA perspective, customer's perspective, bank's perspective, right, we are delivering on time. At the same time, we are ensuring that this capacity is used productively, and you are seeing the best possible growth in the contracting companies in India as far as our growth is concerned. From about 600-700 crore 5 years back, we should be doing 1400-1500 crore of top line in this financial year, and the first 6 months have been the best ever, and the last quarter has also been the best ever. Going forward also, we feel that we are likely to get some good orders, and this should sustain this kind of a momentum. And we are quite bullish that this contracting division should contribute meaningfully to our total revenue, and hope that it should be around 30% or so of the total revenue.
Okay. Can you give us a clear indication of both realty demand as well as pricing across the key areas of operations? Because so far we've seen that South India, particularly Bangalore, that has done quite well. Do you believe that that kind of a trend can continue?
Of course, yes. See, the Bangalore and probably now Hyderabad also, they have been absorbing the maximum possible commercial space, which means that the migration to these cities have been happening where the prices are still right, both for the commercial space, lease rentals, as well as for the home buyers as far as the per square feet is concerned. So these are the two markets where we believe that the growth story can continue for decades. Of course, in a cyclical sector, some may pluses, minuses, overcapacity, weak players coming and spoiling sort of things will happen. But the secular growth is expected. We will also get into Hyderabad market next year. We are planning to get into Trivandrum market also next year. We are also working out something in Hosur. We have lined up about 10 million square feet of new launches, and we are reasonably confident that our dominance in the southern markets should continue in the near foreseeable future.
Okay. What's your take on the steps taken by the finance minister to revive the sector? You know, do you think more funds will be required to be infused?
See, this is a mathematics all of us are doing. I would feel that this 25,000 crore rupees, if it can be given through LIC, through State Bank of India, say within next 45 days time, on a viable basis, the last mile bridge loan, that will itself ensure that those stalled projects not only get started, the existing customer should start paying to the developers or to the banks, as the case may be, as well as the new sales also will start happening. Because of these stalled projects, the sentiments in our sector is not getting revived, though the core demand remains intact. And from that perspective, I think this is the right move, and the finance minister is on record that if more fund is required, they should be able to organize. And we should believe that.
Okay, do you think that majority of the stressed and stuck projects can be revived through this alternative investment fund that has been floated by the government and is going to be run by SBI Asset Managers? How have you looked at this move, and do you believe it is steps in the right direction, but a lot more still needs to be done?
See, this is a question where you can argue either way. What the finance minister is doing is to ensure that the viable projects, because of the cash flow issues, there is an authority which has been solely created as an alternative investment funds to ensure that viable projects within certain criteria on a square feet basis, on the pricing basis, on the completion basis, on the sales basis sort of a thing, can be revived. Even if that gets revived, in a free economy, we should not be shedding tears for those unviable projects where there is no equity left. Somewhere those projects must also have their natural, what you should say, an outcome. And the viable projects should be able to be taken out from these kind of projects, which this government has done, which should be applauded.
All right. Thanks so much for joining us this morning and taking us through the latest there at Sobha. Mr. Sharma, good chatting with you. Okay, let's go across to Kunal, also stick.